Have you ever felt like you work hard, bring home a paycheck, but then, poof, it's gone? Like magic, your money disappears into thin air. You're not alone. Many of us fall victim to the mystery of the disappearing paycheck. But fear not, dear viewer, we're about to embark on a journey to uncover the culprits behind this financial whodunit.
Welcome to Business Alchemy.
Meet Sarah, a bright and bubbly accountant with a not-so-bright bank account. Every month, Sarah diligently worked, but her bank account remained perpetually empty. Where was her money going? Sarah decided to become her own financial detective. Sarah was like a magician with her money, but not in a good way. Every month, she'd get paid, feeling excited and ready to tackle the world. But then, poof, like a disappearing act, her money would vanish faster than a rabbit in a hat. It was a mystery. She'd work hard, see the money come in, but then, nothing. It felt like she was constantly playing financial whack-a-mole, with bills popping up everywhere. Sarah knew something had to change. She was determined to uncover the secret behind her disappearing paycheck. The latte lurker. We've all encountered this sneaky villain at some point. It's that daily habit of grabbing that fancy coffee on the way to work, or that afternoon pick-me-up that seems harmless at first. But those few bucks here and there can really add up over time, leaving Sarah wondering where all their money went. Think of it like this. Let's say Sarah spends $5 every day on a fancy latte. That's $35 a week, a whopping $140 a month, and over $1,600 a year. That's a lot of money that could be going towards something Sarah really wants, like a dream vacation or that gadget she's been eyeing. The comparison caper. Sarah compares her lifestyle to others, leading to impulse buys. Here's the thing. Social media is a highlight reel, not real life. People tend to only show their best moments. Sarah, in the story, fell victim to this. She'd see her friends' pictures and think, "I need that too." But that pressure to keep up with everyone else's seemingly perfect lives can lead to serious impulse buys that blow her budget. The key is to remember, everyone's on their own financial journey. Just because someone else has something doesn't mean you need it to be happy. Focus on your own goals and what truly brings you joy, not what someone else's filtered picture portrays. Trying to keep up with the lifestyles of others can lead to overspending. Wealthy people focus on their own financial goals and avoid comparing themselves to others. Credit card chaos. We've all been there, a little bit like Sarah. Imagine your credit card statement as a report card for your spending. Sarah avoids looking at hers, which is kind of like hiding your test results from your parents. Why? Because deep down, she might suspect there might be some bad grades on there. Here's the thing. Credit cards are handy tools, but they can be tricky. If you don't keep an eye on how much you're spending, those little swipes can add up real fast. It's like a monster under your bed, growing bigger and scarier the longer you ignore it. But don't worry, we can slay this credit card chaos monster together. Here's the plan. Peek at the monster, take a deep breath and open that statement. It might not be pretty, but facing it is the first step. Understand the beast. Once you see the charges, you can figure out where your money went. Maybe it was a few too many lattes, or that online shopping spree. Tame the monster. Now that you know your spending habits, you can make a plan. Maybe cut back on some things, or set a budget for your card. Remember, you're not alone in this battle. There are tons of resources and apps to help you track your spending and avoid credit card chaos. And hey, once you conquer this monster, you'll feel so much more in control of your money. The retirement riptide. Sarah hasn't started saving for retirement, leaving her future uncertain. Imagine Sarah looking into a crystal ball. Instead of seeing a magical future, she sees a blurry image of herself. Older, maybe a little lost. It's because Sarah hasn't started saving for retirement, a time when she might not be working anymore. Without saving now, it's like a sneaky riptide pulling her future finances out to sea. Retirement should be a time to relax and enjoy life, maybe travel or spend more time with family. But without saving, that dream future could be out of reach. That's why it's important to start saving a little bit now, even if it seems like forever until retirement. It's like building a treasure chest for your future self. The insurance inattentiveness. Sarah pays for the same insurance without shopping for better rates. T's like having a superhero protecting you, but you're paying them way more than you have to. Here's the deal with Sarah. She's got this insurance, maybe for her car or her apartment, and every year she just pays the bill without a second thought. It's like she's stuck on autopilot. But the thing is, insurance companies, just like stores with different sales, can offer different rates. Imagine Sarah could find the same exact superhero insurance, but for a way better price. That extra money she saves could be used for something fun, like that new gadget she's been eyeing, or a delicious dinner out. So, how do we avoid the insurance inattentiveness? It's simple. Just a little detective work. Grab your magnifying glass. Dedicate a little time to research insurance companies that offer the same coverage as your current plan. Compare quotes. Get quotes from different companies. It's usually pretty easy to do online or over the phone. Be a superhero negotiator. Once you have a better quote, call your current company and see if they can match it. You might be surprised. By putting in a little effort, Sarah can save money on insurance and become a financial superhero. Habit 7. The debt denier. Sarah ignores student loans, leading to stress and financial burden. We've all met Sarah in this situation. Maybe even been Sarah ourselves sometimes. Here's how to explain it in a friendly way. Imagine this. Sarah loves getting those boxes in the mail, except when it's a white envelope from her student loan company. It just sits there on the counter, unopened, like a monster under the bed. Deep down, Sarah knows she needs to deal with it, but facing that number can be super stressful. It feels easier to pretend it's not there, right? But here's the thing. That debt isn't going anywhere, and the longer Sarah ignores it, the bigger and scarier it gets. It can add stress to her whole life, like a nagging headache that won't go away. There's a better way. The good news is, Sarah doesn't have to fight this monster alone. We'll show her some easy steps to tackle that debt and get that feeling of relief. We'll break down the debt into smaller, less scary chunks. It's like taking a giant pizza and cutting it into slices, much easier to handle, right? We'll also show Sarah how to free up some extra cash to put towards those loans. Maybe it's skipping that daily latte or finding a roommate to share expenses. Every little bit helps. By facing her debt head-on, Sarah can finally close that white envelope and move on with a lighter heart. Remember, debt doesn't have to be a monster. With a little planning and some friendly help, you can slay that debt dragon and achieve financial freedom. So, Sarah wasn't the only one facing the mystery of the disappearing paycheck. It turns out, there's a whole gang of sneaky characters out there called the Seven Sins of Spending. They might seem harmless at first, like that tempting latte each morning, but over time, they can really chip away at your financial goals. But don't worry, just like Sarah, you can outsmart these sneaky sins. We'll show you how to identify them in your own life and teach you easy tricks to keep them in check. Remember, taking control of your finances can feel amazing. It's like giving yourself a superpower to achieve your dreams. So, are you ready to banish the seven sins of spending and unlock your financial freedom? Stick around for more tips, and don't forget to subscribe.
Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe.